attend your second year's English major. This video, I'll tell you what have I learned in this course. What I get from speech, I have learned a lot of new vocabulary, grammar, and also I can listen to the pronunciation about words or sentences, which make me better in pronunciation, I think. They also give me too good at the schedule to do the speech too. Yeah, and then I'm done. All of this is I got from speech in this semester. The next section is self-study, what I get from them. Let's check it out. Self-study. This semester, I could manage the times, which makes me more good at discipline in time to do all of this thing. Every week, I had to study vocabulary, listening, speaking, grammar, and reading. I have focused a lot, especially in the reading part, because I love to read. I have no more information, for example, American life. I knew a fact about the road for now in America. There are over 2,742,550 kilometers of road. July 4th, Americans remember the start of their country in 1776 or called Independence Day. What are the other books I had read this semester? Let's find out. Phonology. What is phonology? Phonology is the description of the systems and patterns of speech sounds. This is phonetic symbols tables. They have 24 letters and 20 sounds of vowels. Syllabication rules. This is all of the syllabication rules that I've learned this semester. Word stress. What is word stress? Word stress is your magic key to understanding spoken English. Why is word stress important? In the English language, word stress deal with the syllables involved in each word. If you slightly mispronounce a word, but the primary stress is correct, you can often communicate its meaning. These are the important rules where do you put word stress. Morphology. What is morphology? Morphology is the system of word forming elements and process in a language. Morpheme. The elements of meaning which are called morphemes. Morpheme is the smallest unit of speech sound which can be divided into free morpheme and bound morpheme. Free morpheme is a unit of speech that can stand alone. For example, I study English, this sentence have three morpheme. Bound morpheme. Bound morpheme is a unit of speech that can't stand alone. For example, unhappy, player, cranberry. Alright, next station I will talking about affix and root word. Affix. Affixes consist of prefix and suffix. Prefix is a group of letters which you can add to the beginning of a root word. These are an example of prefix word. Suffix. Suffix is a word ending. It is a group of letters you can add to the end of a root word. These are an example of suffix word. Root word. A root word is a word that has nothing added at the beginning or the end. It stands on its own as a word. It has some meanings. New words can be made from root words by adding prefix and suffix. And these are some examples of root words that I have learning in this course. syntax definition. Syntax is the study of how the sentences are formed. Parts of speech can divide into nouns, verbs, pronouns, adjectives, adverbs, conjunctions, prepositions, interjections, and the last one, articles. Phase. A phase is a group of two more words that go together in a certain order. Types of clause. There are two types of clauses. The first one is independent clause or main clause. An independent clause is complete and can stand alone as a sentence. The second one is dependent clause or subordinate. Clause also contains a subject and verb but cannot stand alone as a sentence. What is predicate? Predicate is the word that shows the action in a sentence. The predicate is everything in the sentence except the subject. Four types of sentences. The first one, declarative sentence, tells something. Second, interrogative sentence, asks a question. Third, exclamatory sentence, shows strong feelings. And the last one, imperative sentence, gives a comment. Sentence types. Sentence types can be divided into 1. Simple sentence, 2. Compound sentence, 3. Complex sentence, and the last one, compound complex sentence. Types of verbs can be divided into action verbs, linking verbs, and helping verbs. This is my video presentation, and all of that I have been learned in this course. I hope all of you guys enjoy my videos. Thanks for watching. Bye.